What is going on, everybody? Got a quick video for you here. This video is for any new and returning players to the division. In this video, we'll be discussing the Dark Zone. The Dark Zone is the only space in the game that supports both PvE and PvP at the same time. It's a unique environment that most players either love or hate, and depending on the day, sometimes it's a little bit of both. As someone who loves the Dark Zone, I log on or log off in either a DZ checkpoint or a safe house. For me, the Dark Zone is the best part of the game. It's toxic, unbalanced, and horrible, while still being beautiful, fantastic, and amazing all at the same time. And this is coming from someone who once hated the Dark Zone and vowed never to return to it. Somewhere around patch 1.2, I left the DZ and became a strictly PvE player. I avoided the DZ like a plague up until about patch 1.6 when I decided to make a return to PvP. Now I love the DZ again. It's my favorite place on the map. Generally, I don't farm for anything besides Div Tech, and I'm simply there for PvP. Also, if I get something while running around the DZ, I know it's not mine until I fully extract it. The DZ has two simple rules. Trust no one, and nothing is yours until you extract it. Everything else is open season. When you embrace the fact that there are only two rules, the DZ becomes the most exciting place in the game. You can go from being the prey to becoming the predator in an instant. Nothing is certain and nothing is off limits. That is the DZ. Again, two rules. Trust no one and nothing is yours until you extract it. This is the part of the game that never gets old because it's always unpredictable. The Dark Zone is the most active PvE farming area in the game. Bosses and landmarks respawn every 10 minutes or so. Contamination events and supply drops begin randomly, but they're generally once every hour. The timing for these events are completely unpredictable, and it's this unpredictable nature that makes the DZ so vibrant. Let's face it, the LZ is dry. Missions become routine. So farming those missions quickly get old. The DZ offers what farming the LZ or farming missions don't: spontaneity. You can go from farming Div Tech to fighting manhunts for 30 minutes at the drop of a hat. This is why the DZ is so amazing. But before we get into that, let's talk about situational awareness. Again, the Dark Zone is the only space in the game that supports both PvE and PvP at the same time. And there is an unofficial dividing line, PvE in the north and PvP in the south. So if you're new to the DZ and you're only looking to farm PvE, stay out of the lower DZ. The unofficial PvE zones are DZ7 to DZ9. Learn those areas like the back of your hand. And by learn it, I mean you don't need to open your map to know where you are or where you're going. In the description below, I've linked an amazingly detailed map of the Dark Zone. This map contains the location of every Div Tech box, sealed cache, and Dark Zone chest. It also contains the location of every boss and landmark separated by faction. In short, this map is a farmer's best friend. Study it like it's the gospel. Learn it well. It will give you the knowledge you need to get in and get out of the DZ safely. But getting around the DZ is all about repetition and routine. By creating a route and sticking to it, you will learn that route well. You will also notice when something is off about your route. Everything in the DZ is shared. So if a box or a chest is down, that means someone recently opened it. As you are moving through the DZ, watch your surroundings. Players move differently than NPCs. You can see them clear as day from down the block. So stay invisible, because the only time you want players to see you is when you want to be seen. Always cover your tracks. If you are farming multiple landmarks, never travel in a predictable pattern. Learn the shortcuts, rooftops, and alleyways. When you see something strange, disappear. Don't think, run, and disappear. This is why you need to learn the map, because you'll know the shortcuts that others won't. So when shit goes sideways, and shit always goes sideways, you will be the one to come out clean on the other side. And this leads us to our next topic, extracting. All loot drops in the Dark Zone must be extracted. When it's time to extract, be smart. Always keep your eye on the kill feed to see how far away rogues are before you even think about extracting. Only extract when you are full, and always extract from the same place and follow the same procedure. Call your extraction and leave the immediate area. This is especially important for solo players. Leave and watch from a safe distance. If you see anyone come up to your extraction, disappear. Do not assume that person is friendly. Remember the rules. Trust no one Go to a safe house or checkpoint and change servers if necessary. If no one shows, wait until about 30 seconds left on the extraction timer, then run to the rope. You can tell no one has been there because the NPCs will be undisturbed. Try to time it so that there's less than 10 seconds when you put your bag on the rope. This means they'll have to hurry if they want to cut it. And if you drop a fire grenade on them before they can cut it, they will automatically release the rope. This is where you begin to run and lose them in the dark zone that you know like the back of your hand. We'll talk about fighting back when you master running. For now, when you see an agent, you run, Neo. And this brings us to our most important topic, rogues. Every story needs a villain, and in the dark zone, it's rogue players. And on that note, let's pause for a minute for some quick clarification. Not every rogue player is out to gank your loot. I know this is the current consensus, but it's simply not true. What is true is that all gankers are rogue players. So all rogues are often grouped together, but we are not the same. Some rogues, like myself, are just PvP players that want to fight other PvP players. These players tend to stay in the lower DZ like I mentioned before. Gankers tend to hang out in the upper DZ where the farmers are. Those rogues are mainly looking to terrorize PvE farmers. That's because they expect farmers to be easy targets. And this is why it's so important to be a ghost when farming. You don't want to attract the wrong type of attention. Since I was strictly PvE for such a long time, out of respect for those who only want to PvE in the DZ, I don't mess with farmers. To each his own, but that's just my thing. If you see me and I'm rogue, as long as you don't shoot at me, I won't shoot back. If you back away from me, I'll back away from you. To me, this means you are not interested in PvP. But if PvP's your thing, you're in the right place. Watch the lower left corner of the screen for the kill feed. If you're looking for some action, simply head in the direction of the last kill. If you're not interested, simply head in the opposite direction. In the upper left corner, watch for manhunts and rogue activity. Even though the DZ is lawless, there are those who take it upon themselves to enforce order. These brave souls are known as rogue hunters. Rogue hunting can be the most exhilarating part of the Dark Zone. As a non-rogue player, the odds are in your favor. There are 24 players in a server. Players tend to avoid each other, but nothing brings them out like rogue activity. So if you're new to rogue hunting and you see rogues, just wait for more players to show up before you jump in. It's much easier to fight them when you outnumber them. Keep following this format until you are confident enough to take them on yourself. And if you think you're good and you want a challenge, simply go rogue. If you're in a live server, you'll find out real quick just how good you truly are. By far the best PvP in the game is going rogue and eventually manhunt. Surviving a manhunt is the most difficult yet exhilarating experience in the game. And it's even more amazing if you try to do it solo. Remember, nothing brings out rogue hunters like rogue activity, and nothing sends them to you in droves like going manhunt. Like I said, it's the hardest PvP in the game, because no matter what, you will always be outnumbered and outgunned. So it's simply a matter of time before you get overwhelmed. This is why manhunt isn't always about winning as much as it is about surviving for as long as you can and taking out as many as possible. Whether in a four-man squad or running solo, it's only so long before the smart rogue has to turn and run. And to close this video out, let's talk about switching servers. For whatever the reason may be, you may want to change from one DZ server to another. Maybe you're being trolled by rogues, maybe your server is being farmed to shit. Or maybe you just want a more active PvP server. Simply head to the nearest checkpoint. If you're in a group, leave the group, open your map, and matchmake for any activity in the LZ. Be it a mission, an incursion, it doesn't matter. When you get a match, join the new group. When you load in, walk back into the DZ and leave that group. Congratulations, you are now in a new server. If you were in a group, just send your buddies an invite. You might transfer again, because remember, each server only holds 24 players. But either way, you'll be in a completely different server. Also remember that this can only be done in a checkpoint, because matchmaking doesn't work in DZ safe rooms. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching. Take care, everybody.